Now let us solve problems on OC and SC test. So this is the topic of for module 1 single phase transformer. We are going to have calculation of efficiency and voltage regulation along with equivalent circuit parameters using OC and SC test. So OC and SC test, it is used to calculate the equivalent circuit parameters by using which we can calculate efficiency and voltage regulation of single phase transformer. So before going to solve the problems based on OC and SC test, so if I want to calculate efficiency from OC and SC test, let us see what are the formulas we require. Calculation of efficiency from OC and SC test. So from OC test, what all parameters will be given? You can note down here. The given parameters from OC test, that is iron loss. From SC test, that is WSC, that is full load copper loss. So with this given information, how to calculate full load efficiency, percentage eta. So symbol for efficiency is eta here. Percentage efficiency on full load. What is the formula to calculate efficiency using from OC and SC test? V2 I2 FL, that is V2 into full load current cos pi divided by V2 I2 FL, that is full load current cos pi plus W0 iron loss, that is plus copper loss, that is WSC into 100. So this is the formula for full load condition, right? So thus for any power factor cos pi 2, the efficiency can be predetermined. Similarly at any load which is fraction of full load, and then efficiency can be predetermined as. So here if any other power factor condition is given and any other loading condition is given, in that case you can make use of this formula. Percentage efficiency at any load is given by wherever current I2 will appear, there I told you you should take loading factor, that is small n into VA rating cos pi divided by n, because here also I2 is appearing one time. So n into VA rating cos pi plus iron loss, that is W0, plus copper loss. Copper loss is I square R, so L square into WSC into 100. So this is the formula to calculate efficiency for full load condition, and this is the formula to calculate efficiency at any loading condition and for any given power factor condition, where N indicates fraction of full load. If it is 20%, means take N as 0.2. If it is 50%, means N value is 0.5, 0.5, 0.5 whole square. In this way, you have to take the loading condition. And if it is 0.8 power factor condition, means cos pi, should take it here as 0.8. If it is cos pi 0.6, means here you should take this as 0.6. It all depends upon the problem statement. The same thing, percentage eta n is equal, that is percentage efficiency is equal to n into V2 I2. Here V2 means V, I2 means ampere, volt into ampere is V2 I2, cos pi is given, divided by once again n loading condition, this V2 ampere I2 cos pi plus iron loss plus copper loss for any loading condition, n square into WSC into 100, where I2 is equal to n into full load current I2 FL. Similarly, how to calculate regulation using OC and SC test? Let us see here. Calculation of regulation from SC test, we get the equivalent circuit parameters referred to primary or secondary, right? So how to calculate the regulation and what is the formula? So to calculate the percentage regulation using equivalent circuit parameters, percentage regulation R is given by I2 R2E cos pi plus or minus I2 X2E sin pi divided by V2 into 100. So here we can take secondary parameters to calculate regulation. In that case, we should follow this formula: plus for lagging power factor, minus for leading power factor. If you are having equivalent circuit parameters referred to primary side, then you should take this formula. What is that? I1 R1E cos pi plus for lag, minus for lead, I1 X1 is sine pi divided by V1 into 100. So it all depends what parameters we are provided with, whether it is primary side or secondary side. If it is primary side, then you should use this formula for calculation of regulation from in using OC and SC test information. Similarly, if it is secondary side parameters, means we should make use of this formula, right? using the same formulas for regulation and for efficiency. Now let us find out some performance parameters like efficiency, regulation using OC and SE test. So now we will discuss problem on OC and SE test. If 5 kV, this is the problem on OC and SE test. If 5 kVA 500 bar 250 volt 50 hertz single phase transformer give the following readings. So here we have conducted OC and SE test, and OC test information is given as no load voltage 500, this is V naught, no load current I naught is 1 ampere, and iron loss is 50 watts. Iron loss is 50 watts. So here in the bracket they have given as LV side is open. LV side is open means instruments are connected on HV side. Instruments are connected on HV side means LV side is open means instruments are connected on HV side. Then similarly SC test. SC test is short circuit voltage. VSC is given as 25 volts. Then 10 ampere is short circuit current. ISC is 10 ampere. And full load copper loss, that is WSC, is 60 watt. So here once the instruments are connected on primary side means in the bracket they are telling that LV side is shorted. LV shorted means secondary side is shorted and instruments are connected on primary side means HV side is primary. Similarly in the OC test in the bracket they are giving that LV side is open. If LV side is open means instruments like wattmeter, ammeter, voltmeter, they are connected on the primary side. So all these parameters they are referred to primary. Here LV is open, LV side is open, secondary side is LV, that is the meaning. With the given data, determine first one, efficiency on full load. Efficiency of full load means N is 1 and power factor is 0.8 lag. Similarly, second one is voltage regulation on full load at 0.8 leading power factor. Third one is efficiency on 60% of full load, that is N is 0.6. Then power factor is 0.8 leading here, leading power factor. Then finally, draw the equivalent circuit, refer to primary and insert all the values in it. So whatever equivalent circuit parameters we have calculated using OC and SE test, so we need to draw the equivalent circuit and we have to substitute all the values in that equivalent circuit. Okay. So this is one of the important question which may be asked in the exam. So problem like this, you have to practice here. This is a 12 marks question which has appeared in the VTU. Okay, now you can see the solution here. In both the tests, meters are on HV side, which is primary. Here only you can make the judgment. OC test means always for the OC test, high voltage side should be kept open. If high voltage side means that is secondary side, if it is kept open means meters will be connected on LV side. But here the case is reverse. LV side is open means secondary side is LV, which is open means primary will be HV, that is the meaning. In the second also, LV is shorted. So LV is shorted means your secondary side is low voltage winding, it is shorted. If LV is shorted means instruments are on primary side and test is conducted on what is that, primary side only. So in both the cases, instruments means measuring instruments, voltmeter, ammeter and wattmeter, they are connected on primary side, that is the meaning. Solution: in both the test, meters are on the HV side, which is primary of the transformer. Hence, parameters obtained from tests will be referred to primary. So, whatever results we are noting down from the measuring instruments, they are all parameters referred to primary because all the meters are connected on the primary side. So, now note down all the given parameters from OC test. What is the no load voltage? Here, no load voltage V naught is 500 volts. No load voltage is denoted as V naught. Similarly, no load current is denoted as I naught, which is 1 ampere. And from the OC test, we know that it is going to give us iron loss, that is W naught. No load loss is, that is iron loss, that is PI or W naught, that is equal to 50 watt. So with this, we calculate no load power factor. No load power factor from OC test, we know that no load power factor is given by W naught divided by V naught into I naught. So W naught is 50. V naught is no load voltage is 500 and no load current is 1. So no load power factor is 0.1 ampere. Now you calculate what is I. I is equal to I naught cos pi naught, that is IC. The active component IC is I naught cos pi naught. I naught is what value here? I naught is 1 and cos pi naught is 0.1. So once again, my active component IC will be 0.1 ampere. Similarly, magnetizing component, always remember from no load test, from no load test we are getting magnetizing branch component parameters. So cos pi naught IC, then IM, IM is I naught sine pi naught, I naught is how much, 1 ampere. Sine pi naught means sine of cos inverse of 0.1, which will be 0.1. I naught is anyhow it is 1 ampere. Sine of cos inverse of 0.1 means 0.9949 ampere. So with the information of IC, that is active component, then magnetizing component IM, next calculate magnetizing branch component parameter, that is R naught. R naught is nothing but a ratio of no load voltage divided by active component IC. V naught is how much here? V naught is 500 and IC is 0.1. 500 divided by 0.1 will be 5 kilo ohms, that is 5000 ohms. Then X naught, one another parameter of magnetizing branch, X naught is V naught divided by magnetizing current IM. So V naught is 500 and IM is how much here, 0.9949, which will be X naught is equal to 502.52 ohms. Now iron loss W naught, the iron loss W naught is nothing but Pi, that is equal to 50 watt. So IC, IM, R naught, X naught and cos pi naught, all these equivalent circuit parameters we have calculated from OC test. Now the remaining parameters of equivalent circuit parameters you calculate from SC test. Now from SC test, VSC, VSC is short circuit voltage, is given as 25 volts. This is given in the data here, you can see here VSC is 25 volts, ISC is 10 ampere, WSC, that is full load copper loss, is 60 watt. This you have to rewrite once again. So VSC is 25 volts, ISC is 10 amperes, WSC is 60 watt. So we know that from the SC test, we will come to know equivalent resistance, R1E. Equivalent resistance on primary side is R1E. Its formula is WSC by ISC square. WSC is how much, full load copper loss is 60 and short circuit current ISC is 10 square. 60 by 100 is 0.6 ohms. Similarly, Z1E, primary equivalent impedance, that is Z1E is nothing but VSC by ISC. So VSC here is 25 and ISC is 10. 25 by 10 is 22.5 ohms. Calculate corresponding reactance. X1 is square root of Z1E square minus R1E. Z1E is 2.5 whole square and R1E is 0.6 whole square. So the value of equivalent, primary equivalent reactance X1E is 2.4269 ohms. So once we get this R1E, X1E, this will help us to calculate regulation, right? Now calculate what is full load current. So full load primary current is nothing but VA rating divided by voltage. VA rating is 5 kVA. So it is, what is that? 5 kVA, 5000 volt ampere. It is given in the problem statement, you can see here. It is 5 kVA, 5 × 10⁻³. 5 × 10⁻³, and primary voltage is also given, that is 500. So the full load primary current is 10 ampere. Now, what is a WSC? WSC is nothing but full load copper loss, that is PCU FL, that is equal to 60 watts. Now you calculate the parameters. So the first parameter what we should calculate here is, what is the first parameter we should calculate? Efficiency on full load, means N value is full load, means N is 1 and power factor is 0.8. lagging it is. So N here is 1 and power by 0.8. So efficiency formula for any loading condition is VA rating cos pi 2 plus VA rating cos pi 2 plus iron loss plus copper loss. So here full load means N value will be 1. So VA rating is 5 kVA, 5 × 10⁻³, power factor is 0.8 lagging, divided by once again VA rating cos pi, that is 5 × 10⁻³ into 0.8 plus iron loss is 50, that is Pi. This is given in the OC test, and 60 is the full load copper loss. This is given in the short circuit test. Iron loss will be obtained from OC test and copper loss will be obtained from SC test, and multiplied with 100, then full load efficiency at connected load of 0.8 lagging will be 97.32%. So here, without connecting any load, if the load power factor is 0.8 lagging, that too it is carrying, if it is carrying 100% load, means the efficiency of the transformer will be 97.32%. Right. Then the second parameter what we should calculate here is voltage regulation on full load means n is 1 at 0.8 leading power factor. Leading means we should take minus sign in the formula. What is the formula for regulation? Regulation is given by second one. Regulation on full load, that too caused by 0.8 leading. So percentage regulation is nothing but I1 FL R1E caused by, here we should take minus because of leading power factor, I1 FL XNE sin pi divided by V1 into 100. So now full load current we have calculated. So what is the full load current here? Full load current I1 is 10 ampere. So here to calculate the regulation, we are taking the help of all the parameters referred to primary side only. Primary current, primary equivalent resistance, primary equivalent reactance and primary voltage. Everything is primary side parameters only. So I1 is 10 ampere, R1 is 0.6. So R1E, from where we are getting? From SC test. You can see here, from SC test we have calculated R1E, and from SC test we have calculated X1E, that is 2.4. These two values now we are going to make use in the calculation of regulation. So R1E is 0.6, given power factor is 0.8, since it is leading, take minus sign. I1 once again 10 ampere, then X1 is 2.4269. If cos pi is 0.8, then sin pi is 0.6. It means that sine of cos inverse of 0.8 will be 0.6 divided by primary voltage V1 is 500 into 100, that is equal to minus 1.95%, means because it is leading power factor, means regulation will be getting negative. Then the third parameter what we have to calculate here is efficiency on 60% of full load. So efficiency on 60% means n is small, n is 0.6 and leading power factor 0.8. so here third parameter we should calculate efficiency. So for 60% of full load, n is 0.6 and cos pi 2 is 0.8 leading. So for 60% loading condition, calculate what is the full load, what is the associated copper loss. PCV is nothing but copper loss on full load into n square, that is n is 0.6 whole square into full load copper loss. This is 60, this is available for us from SC test data, that is WSC, 60 into 0.6, 60% loading. So it will be 21.6 watt. Now calculate efficiency for any loading condition. So here n into VA rating cos pi 2 divided by n into VA rating cos pi 2 plus iron loss plus copper loss. So here it is connected for 60% loading, means n you have to take it as 0.6, VA rating is 5 kVA, that is 5 × 10⁻³, cos pi is 0.8. once again same values, 0.6 5 × 10⁻³ into 0.8, plus iron loss is 50 watts and copper loss for 60% loading condition we have calculated here, whose value is 21.6. substitute here and multiply it with 100. So efficiency at 60 for 0.8 leading power factor will be 97.103%, right? And what is the last parameter we should calculate here? We should draw the equivalent circuit referred to primary. So secondary parameters we should transfer it to primary, and all whatever parameters we have calculated, that is R0, X0, what is that? You can see here, this is IC, this is IM, R0, X0, then R1E, Z1E, X1E. All these are the what? These are the equivalent circuit parameters. These equivalent circuit parameters values you should insert in that equivalent circuit diagram. So the fourth parameter what you are supposed to draw is equivalent circuit referred to primary. So equivalent circuit referred to primary means this is my primary current magnetizing branch, which is I0, IC, IM, R0, X0. So R1E, X1E and combination will be Z1E. So R1E is nothing but R1 plus R2 dash, X1E is nothing but X1 plus X2 dash. Then R1E, this value we have calculated from SC test, that is 0.6. X1E we have calculated as 2.4269, and its combination, that is the impedance Z1E, is we have calculated from SC test. What is the value of Z1E? It is 2.5 ohms. If you want, you can write the value of Z1 as 2.5 ohms. And no load current is 1 ampere. IC is whatever we have calculated in the earlier stage. You write the value for IC, you write the value for IM, you write the value of R0, which is 5 kilo ohms or 5000 ohms. X0 is 502.52 ohms. And primary voltage is 500 volts. And this is load terminal voltage referred to primary side, V2 dash. And this is the load which is referred to primary side, that is ZL dash. So this is the equivalent circuit. And whatever equivalent circuit parameters you have obtained from OC and SC test, all those values you have to write it here. So IC, IM, R0, X0, I0, all these values you have calculated from OC test. R1, X1, Z1 you have calculated from SC test. So whatever the values you have calculated, just you insert those values. R1 is this much, X1 is 2.4269 ohms. Then similarly, IM, IC, R0, X0, all those values you have to write it here, okay? Now let us see the another problem based on OC and SC test. Remember, OC and SC test, it is used to calculate efficiency and regulation. Okay. The next type of problem on OC and SC test is, you can see here, problem statement is, the following readings are obtained from OC and SC tests on 8 kVA, 8 kVA transformer, 400 bar 120 volts, voltage, primary voltage is 400, secondary voltage is 120, it is step down transformer, 50 hertz transformer. So OC test data, so you can see here OC test is conducted on LV side. So LV means, you can see here 400 is higher voltage and 120 is lower voltage. So OC test means it is connected, OC test on LV side means all the instruments they are connected on LV side. LV means secondary side, so all these are secondary side information, 120 volt. So OC test which is conducted on LV side, no load voltage V0 is 120 volts, I0 no load current is 4 ampere, and copper loss W0 or PI is 75 watts. Similarly, short circuit test, short circuit test it is conducted on HV side. HV side means what is that? HV side means high voltage side. High voltage side is primary. So if test is conducted on primary side means secondary side is what is that? Shorted. So all the here instruments are connected on primary side, here instruments are connected on primary side, and secondary side is shorted. So short circuit test, short circuit voltage VSC is given as 9.5 volt, short circuit current IS is given as 20 amps, and short full load copper loss PCU, FL or WSC is 110 watts. So with the given information of OC and SC test, calculate first one equivalent circuit constants, then voltage regulation and efficiency for 0.8 lagging power factor full load. So n value is 1, but efficiency and regulation you should calculate it for cos pi 0.8 lagging. Then third one, efficiency at half load and 0.8 full load. So here the third one is, you should calculate efficiency for half load. Half load means n is 0.5 and power factor is cos pi is 0.8. okay, first we calculate all the equivalent circuit parameters using OC and SC test. So now solution from OC test, write down all the given parameters. What is this? Iron loss, iron loss PI or W0 is 75, then no load voltage V0 from OC test is 120 volts, and no from OC test no load current I0 is 4 ampere. Then instruments are on LV side. So here you can see that OC test is conducted on low voltage side. Low voltage side means check the voltage here, 400 bar 120. So it is step down transformer. So instruments are connected on LV side means whatever LV, it is on the secondary side. So all these values, they are referred to secondary side. That is the meaning. Instruments are on LV side, that is secondary. So now you calculate cos pi naught. Cos pi naught from using the results of OC test, cos no load power factor cos pi naught is equal to W0 divided by V0 I0. W0 is 75, V0 is 120, I0 is 4. So no load power factor is 0.15625. From this you calculate no sine pi naught. Sine pi naught means sine of cos inverse of 0.15625. It will be 0.9877. Sine of cos inverse of 0.15625, its value will be 0.9877. then we calculate active component IC. IC is nothing but I0 cos pi0. So IC, IM, R0 and X0, all these are the equivalent circuit parameter constants which we have to calculate. That is first parameter. Equivalent circuit constants means IC, IM, I0, R0, X0, R1, X1, all those parameters we have to calculate it. So IC is nothing but I0 cos pi0. So what is I0 value? I0 value is 4 ampere, and cos pi naught is 0.15625, then its value will be 0.625. Then magnetizing component Im is nothing but this is I naught, make this as I naught, this I naught sine pi naught, I naught is once again 4 into sine pi naught is 0.9877, 4 into 0.9877 is 3.9509 ampere. Next, so in the previous problem we have taken R naught as V naught by IC, because there all the instruments they are connected on primary side, but here in this case the instruments are on LV side. LV side is what here, secondary. So secondary side instruments, if I want to secondary side instruments are connected, means I want information with respect to primary side. So for that sake, what you have to do, you have to whatever values they are there, this is nothing but R naught dash here. So because instruments are on the secondary side, so R naught dash is nothing but V naught by IC. V naught is 120 and IC is what here, active component 0.625, that will be giving 192 ohms. Similarly X naught dash, so instruments are on secondary side, for that sake we are taking here this as R naught dash, don't get confused, because instruments are on the secondary side here. Similarly X naught dash, V naught by IM, V naught is no load voltage 120, 3.9509, so that will be 30.3736 ohms. Then K value, V2 by V1, so V2 is given here in this case as 120 divided by V1 is 400, 120 by 400, the value of K is 0.3. Now this is not required for us because instruments are on secondary side, but I want information with respect to primary. So now what we will be doing, convert the things with respect to primary side. So for that sake, the value of R naught is R naught dash divided by K square. R naught dash is 0.3 whole square. So R naught, this is my required value. So R naught is equal to 2133.33 ohms, and similarly X naught is equal to X naught dash divided by K square. So X naught dash here is 30.3736 divided by K square is 0.3 whole square, that is equal to 337.48 ohms. And now these values, they are referred to primary side, and these are the required values for us. But whereas this R naught dash, X naught dash, these are with respect to secondary side, but we want the values with respect to primary side, and the primary side values are R naught and X naught, because always remember magnetizing branch will be on the primary side. For that sake we are taking or considering the values from R naught dash to R naught, and this R naught and this X naught, these are the values which are referred to primary side. Okay. Now from SC test, WSC copper loss is given as 110 watts. WSC, let's see here, WSC is 110, ISC is 20 ampere, VSC is 9.5 volts. So always remember, short circuit means voltage becomes VSC, current becomes ISC, power becomes WSC. If it is no load test, means current becomes I naught, voltage becomes V naught, and power becomes W naught. Always OC test use iron loss and AC test use full load copper loss. Now from the SC test, WSC is, that is copper loss is 110 watts, then short circuit voltage VSC is 9.5 volts, short circuit current ISC is 20 amps. Now instruments are on the HV side. So directly instruments here are on the HV side and LV is shorted. That is, so here you can see that SC test means instruments are on HV side. HV side means LV is shorted. It is in the good, what is that, required condition only, what I can say. It's in the required condition only. So here all the instruments are on the HV side. HV side means primary only, and secondary is what, LV. It is shorted for SC test. So now instruments are on HV side, that is primary. So Z1E is nothing but VSC by ISC. This is the formula of using SC test to calculate Z1E. Z1E is given by ratio of VSC by ISC. VSC is 9.5 and ISC is 20 ampere, that is equal to 0.475 ohms. Then R1E is nothing but WSC by ISC square. WSC by ISC square. WSC is 110 and ISC square is 20 whole square, that will be 0.275 ohms. Once I know Z1E, R1E, calculate equivalent reactance on the primary side. So X1 is nothing but square root of Z1E square minus R1E square. Square root of 0.475 whole square minus 0.275 whole square, that is equal to 0.3873 ohms. So whatever we have calculated so far, that is IC, IM, R0, X0, then Z1E, R1E, X1E, all these are the equivalent circuit constants. Now second, what we have to calculate second is voltage regulation and efficiency at 0.8 lagging power factor full load. N is 1, whereas power factor is 0.8 lagging for this loading condition. Calculate regulation and efficiency, second parameter. Full load means N is 1 and cos pi 0.8 lag. If cos pi is 0.8, means sine pi will be sine of cos inverse 0.8, means 0.6. Sine of cos inverse of 0.8 is equal to 0.6. Pi means what? Pi is equal to cos inverse of 0.8. Like that, you have to take. Now, full load current, primary side, I am to calculate regulation, we are taking all the parameters with respect to primary side. So, here in this case, full load current I1 is equal to VA by V1. So, what is my volt ampere? Volt ampere VA is given here as 8 kVA. 8 kVA means 8 into 10 raised to 3. 8000, that is the meaning. And primary voltage is how much here? V1. Primary voltage is 400. 8 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 400, that this will give us full load primary current. Full load primary current I1 is FL is equal to VA by V1, that is 8 into 10 raised to 3 divided by, it is 400, it is not 4, it is 400. So it will be full load primary current is 20 ampere. So now percentage regulation, R is given as I1 FL full load primary current into R1E cos pi, and now power factor is lagging, so take plus sign, X1E sin pi divided by this numerator part is V1 here, V1 into 100. Substitute the value of I1. I1 is 20, then R1E, R1E is 0.275, then cos pi is 0.8 plus X1E is 0.3873, sin pi is 0.6 divided by V1. V1 is 400 into 100, then regulation will be positive because it is lagging power factor. The regulation value will be 2.262%. Then you should calculate for efficiency. Efficiency is nothing but output by input. Output is VA cos pi divided by input is output plus total loss. Output is VA cos pi plus iron loss plus copper loss. It is full load means 1 here. So VA cos pi, VA here in this case, iron loss is 35 watts. This is given for you in the OC test. Sorry, not 35. Iron loss is 75 watts. This is given for us in the problem statement. So OC test will give us iron loss, that is PI or W0, that is 75 watts. This I have to use. So VA cos pi means 8 into 10 raised to 3, cos pi is 0.8. 8 into 10 raised to 3 is 0.8 plus 75 plus full load copper loss is how much? Full load copper loss is given for us as how much? 110. 110 you have to take in the place of the PCFL. Then after substituting, that is 8 into 10 raised to 3 VA cos pi is 0.8, 8 into 10 raised to 3 into VA, this is once again output plus iron loss plus copper loss, 75 plus 110 into 100, then efficiency will be 97.19%. And similarly, the third parameter what we have to calculate here is efficiency at half load, that is N is equal to 0.5 and power factor is 0.8. Okay, efficiency, eta we have to calculate once again. For half load, efficiency will be N is equal to 0.5, cos pi 0.8. And what is the formula? Percentage eta half load, that is equal to N VA cos pi divided by N VA cos pi plus PI plus N square into PCU FL into 100. So N is 0.5, VA is 8 into 10 raised to 3, cos pi is 0.8. Once again, same value. N is 0.5, VA is 8 into 10 raised to 3, cos pi is 0.8, plus iron loss is 75, plus here in this case, N square means 0.5 whole square. Then copper loss is 110 into 100. So here, the efficiency for 50% loading condition for connected power factor of 0.8, the efficiency will be 96.896%. Okay.